Hey, thank you everyone for joining together for today's Higher Self Inner Circle meeting. I hope that you absolutely love the energy and the meditation and the information and also the answers to the questions that were given. I hope that everything really helps you have a wonderful day as we enter into our final month together. For today, I'm also going to create the first announcement for the next Higher Self Inner Circle that begins in January of 2025. So we're going to roll the inner circles into another year. This will be, I think, our fourth year of doing the inner circles. We started in 2020. Oh my gosh, it'll be the fifth year. We started in 2020, so it's going to be 5 years. Wow. So we're going to roll into the fifth year, and the topic is going to be understanding and experiencing God's love for life. So this next inner circle is going to look at the topic of love, which, as you know, is this great state of happiness. And we're going to try to understand, first off, what universal love is, what that means when the higher self teaches it, and also how can we experience it more fully. So if we look at God in the universe, we realize that the demonstration of this highest form of energy, this highest wisdom that we call love, God's love, we're going to look at how it's demonstrated to us. So if we start to study life, because everything that I teach has to be observable, we have to validate it. I'm not going to just tell you about other planets and other aliens and things that we can't validate with our senses, right? We want to look at things we can actually observe, things we can validate, because we want to create the best life for ourselves. That's why we're here. That's why we're human. So we're going to look at the universe, and we're going to try to understand how God loves and why love is considered this divine frequency. So you'll look through the lens of perception, or look at your life through the lens of God consciousness. We're going to find ways to understand this energy. And we're also going to do practices to open our spiritual heart and raise our vibration into these higher states of love. You're going to be taught about things like unconditional love and acceptance for yourself. Because when we start to realize what God is, one of the things we see is God is unconditional love. And in spirituality, we're encouraged to have more of this unconditional love for ourselves and for others. So what does that mean? How can we actually live an example of genuine unconditional love? That's a confusing question for many of us, because sometimes we think we're giving unconditional love, but then we find out that we're getting hurt in the process, right? We kept loving someone, and they kept walking all over us, abusing us or using us. Oh, that didn't seem very wise. If we were living according to this divine energy, then there shouldn't have been harm that happened, right? So we're going to look at unconditional love for ourselves and unconditional love for each other. We're also going to realize that this love is a unity consciousness state. So what does that even mean? With all these teachings of non-duality and unity consciousness, what is it that's actually observable that is unity consciousness? And if divine love is this unity energy, right, how can we get into it in a way that's real? Because sometimes the non-duality teachings are very philosophical, very intellectual, and they sound beautiful and romantic, but they don't really do much to change our experience. Right? Sometimes we might just sit back proud because we know this idea. We like to talk to ourselves about these beautiful concepts, but at the end of the day, our life didn't really change all that much. We're not that much happier because of these concepts we learned. So if non-duality and unity consciousness and unity energy is a real thing, how can we actually experience it? And what happens when we get into this higher state of divine love, which is the unity of all life? So what's one thing we're going to investigate as well? Another property of divine love is healing. So some of us might be curious about energy healing. And we understand that emotional suffering and the damage and trauma we've experienced emotionally causes illness in the body and mind. But when we're exposed to angelic energies, or even if we have an out-of-body experience and we feel these higher vibrations of life, these higher dimension energies of God, that divine love heals our body and heals our emotions. Well, how does that work? And how can we get into that energy of divine love for our own self-healing? And if we're going to work as energy healers, how can we channel that divine love to help other people heal? So these are just some examples of how we're going to investigate this idea of divine love, of this perfect unity state of vibration. So we're going to do that for the next 3 months, January, February, and March of 2025. As always, we meet on Sunday for 3 to 4 hours. You get the recordings every week. You also get one guided meditation each week. You can keep those recordings and use the meditation each day. The price will stay the same. I know I've been doing it for 5 years, but I'm going to keep it at the same price of $333.33 for the 3 months of teachings. It seems like I just keep teaching longer each lesson, so now it's probably coming out to like $7 or $6 an hour for teachings, which I think is a great value for everyone. So I hope you take advantage of this, because I just love teaching and I want to keep doing this. And I want to offer you new ways of understanding your life and awakening in your reality. So this will be a new topic, understanding and experiencing divine love from that level of God consciousness. So what does God's love actually mean? And how can we truly understand it, see examples of it, and experience it for ourselves? So you can sign up at any time. I'll be posting instructions this week and posting this announcement this week like I usually do. And you can sign up at any time, and we'll start on the first Sunday of January. Have a wonderful week, everyone. For those of you who celebrated Thanksgiving this week, I hope you had a beautiful time with your friends, family, and loved ones. And we're rolling up on another holiday soon. So this is always a very, very fun month in which we remember the love that we have for each other and the love that we can share for the world. We're moving towards the celebration of Christ consciousness at the end of the year. So keep embodying your spiritual heart. Keep shining that divine love and light that you have for this world. Take care. God bless. And I'll see you next Sunday.